Hi friends, welcome to the SQL Server training session. This is Mamta Rajput and today's topic is Qolis function in SQL Server. So we'll discuss what is Qolis function in SQL Server and what's its use. So let's get started. Qolis function is used to return the first not null values in the list. Okay, it returns the first not null values among the list of expression which is passed into this function. Okay, so we can pass the number of arguments, or we can say number of expression inside the Qolis function, and which is having a null values, and this function will return the first not null values. So let me give an example to better understand it. For a demonstration purpose, I have used the AdventureWorks 2014 database, and in this database I have a person table. So let me fetch the top 5. Let me zoom in. So here I am fetching the top 5 records from this table. When you look into the table, you can see here the column first name, middle name and last name. These three columns is of null type, is of nullable type, and it contains the null values as well. Okay. So if we want, suppose this type of the records you want to display in your report or in your application, so displaying null value is not a good practice. So if you want to display the name of a person, either first name, middle name, last name, whatever has a value, not null value, whatever it has a value, that means if a first name, middle name and last name, all three is available, then it will display all the three values. But in this case, in third row, if you see here, first name, we have a value for a first name column, but we do not have a value for the middle name. So instead of displaying Roberto null and this value, we want to display the first null value, that is Roberto. Okay, so if you want to see, suppose want to display few columns like business identity ID first, instead of displaying all the columns, so I'll remove the asterisk and I mention the column names. Suppose title, first name, middle name, last name. Okay. So these are the values. So if you select this query and try to execute it, you will get the same result having the null value. But if you don't want to see this null value for these three columns, so what you can do, you can insert all these three columns inside the Qolis function. So you can specify, you can give n number of the arguments or n number of the expression inside the Qolis function. Okay, and given alias name. Alias is nothing but a logical name for a column. Try to execute this. See, here you can see Qolis function will return the first not null value among these three columns. Okay, for the third row, if you remember, Roberto is the name, is the not null, is the first is the value for the first name column. Okay, if you want to see what is the difference among all three columns, so you can explicitly mention here those columns to check. Give alias name here and remove it to check the differences. See, this is the column which is not having a null value. Okay, it returns the first not null value. So first not null values among these three columns is this came. For second row, the value is Terry. Okay, so Terry would come into this column. Okay, for third row, there is a Roberto, then null, then this value. So Roberto is the first not null value. Okay, let's say I have a null value here. So null value in this column, in this column. I have only the not null value here. So the instead of Rob, Walter will be available here. Okay, second example is if you have this values like null, second, then test, null. So these are the list of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 values inside the colon. So it will, as per its definition, it will return the first not null value. So first not, very first not null value here you can see is the test. So it will provide us the value test. Okay. So I hope you understand what is the meaning of colon in SQL Server. Thank you so much. Hope you like the video. Have a nice day.